We are seeing a dramatic change in direction here in the short term for stocks. Will there be stimulus? Trillions in just a few months apparently isn't enough. Fiscal, monetary, and public works. Nothing is ever enough. More stimulus will come. The wave will flood the markets. The financial system will be saturated with liquidity. But in the meantime, algorithms are not too happy. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. As you know, I get into the real deal. I bring you the data. You do what you want with the data. I'm looking at all of these details today, including what's been happening with the stimulus. I'm talking about the deficit. I'm going to give you an update on the Federal Reserve's balance sheet. I have a lot to cover here in this one. We're going to cover several different topics. I want to bring it all back around. Let's begin. This article here out of CNBC is essentially talking about how there will be no more stimulus talks until after November 3rd. Apparently, this is the issue that stocks are worried about, and as a result, at the time of this recording, stocks had dropped down. Then you will see, as time goes on, how, well, we're very uncertain, so the stock market gets a little shaky. It's so strange to me because there has already been so much support, both from the Federal Reserve, with their interest rates, with all of their different programs. Just imagine, since September of last year, the Federal Reserve has been intervening at an absolute historic level, and then it continued on into the new year. They were doing the repo, then it moved in to actual official QE. They never admitted it, what they were doing, of course, but at some point, they had an excuse. Then we moved into this era of stimulus. They pumped it in everywhere that they could. Now, here today, without that second round of stimulus, the markets are saying, how can we go up any further? We need more stimulus. And it's not just, of course, for the markets, but the markets love it. If you look at Main Street, Main Street's been suffering. The restaurant industry, the movie industry, retail is taking a hard hit. You look at commercial real estate. There are so many different levels of this. It goes real deep. And unfortunately, many jobs are permanently gone. That's one of the issues that they talk about here. I've got that article, I believe it's the next one or the one after, where permanent job losses are rising. I've shown you the charts. I've shown you all that encompasses what we're seeing in the jobs market. It's a very interesting one. It is unique. I know that we'll be looking back on this 20 years from now and seeing how out of sync a lot of this has really been. It's unusual, to say the least. I posted about this on the blog or community section on my channel, and it's just, you know, I do a service for the community, and that is watching Jerome Powell and the Federal Reserve speak so that you don't have to, so that you don't have to be bored, so that you don't have to sit there clawing your eyes out. I mean, oh my goodness, it is just ridiculous, the softballs that they throw at this guy. How about asking him the question, when will you stop taking all of the assets? This is ridiculous, but no, not even close. I mean, I've seen some that have been certainly better than others, but over the years, it has been just softball after softball. I'm not even asking about the origins of the Federal Reserve and ending the Fed. Just give a question that is actually meaningful. Every single time they ask a question, he simply reads off the paper. The statement is already provided. It is a complete waste of time. Reporters, please ask something meaningful. Give me something. Fed Chair Powell calls for more help from Congress, says there's a low risk of overdoing it. Well, thanks, Mr. Powell. There's a low risk of overdoing the amount of stimulus. Well. I mean, the talk that you can get away with pumping in as much money as you want with no repercussions should be banished from the face of the earth, because we know that is a lie. The risks of overdoing it seem, for now, to be smaller. It is truly unfortunate to see the way that this has progressed, and it doesn't seem to be stopping anytime soon. This article here is just getting into more details about Jerome Powell and what he had to say, essentially suggesting that without more money printing, without more stimulus, they're not going to be able to have a strong recovery. At the bottom here, they mentioned the permanent layoffs. The number of permanent layoffs have been rising after a lot of workers were initially classified as having temporarily, let me just put some quotations around that here, temporarily losing their jobs. I love that. They do the furloughs, and that has actually hit the real problem that we've seen. I don't know if I kept that article in here, but essentially more and more people today are suggesting that the economy is getting better. We are seeing this V-shaped recovery. We are watching the unemployment rate, which had spiked upward. Now it is declining down. What was it? 7.9% or something laughable? It's a joke. It's a joke. So many people today, still today, are furloughed, okay? They're incorrectly using this term. And as a result, these people here don't end up on the official numbers, but they're not getting paid. They're not working. Maybe they're getting money from the government, but that's not sustainable. Look at the deficit. Look at the problems that are underlying this system. Even Jerome Powell himself, and I quote, "The U.S. federal budget is on an unsustainable path, has been for some time. But this is not the time to give priority to those concerns." That's right. It wasn't all the way through after the financial crisis, after you said that the financial crisis had ended. And then what happened all those years? They didn't fix it. They didn't change anything. Of course not. Here, this is the article I wanted to talk about. Southwest asked employees to accept pay cuts to avoid furloughs. Airline says it can avoid job cuts through next year with union deals. So, you want to keep your job? Absolutely no problem. We're not going to get rid of you. You just got to take a haircut. How about 20%? How about 30%? How about 50%? What's it going to be? Are they going to do it in stages? Maybe certain people, 20% off the top. Then we get into next year. Sorry, we want to keep you on. Well, it's 30% and it's 40%. And so on. What happens when it's time to get a raise down the road? Or maybe the economy has recovered. Are you going to then increase those people's salary back to where it was before? Now they're behind 3 years. Now they've got problems because all of their expenses have risen. Their electricity prices have risen throughout this period. Their food prices, I know I've seen the comments, inflation in the food prices is very evident. And why? Because they've been pumping the money in. You know what's going on. It isn't just because one or two things, because we had a shortfall, because of the supply chain, that is a factor, let's be honest. But what's happening right now is very, very evident. But anyway, back on this issue, when we look at the furloughs, it is disguising the real problem underneath, and you're never going to get that admission from the mainstream media. You're never going to see the suits and ties on television telling you that, but I'll say it. I don't care how many people hate me for it. Chopped Judge Marcus Samuelson: failure to pass restaurant aid would cost millions of jobs. If we don't get this bill passed, I don't know what's going to happen to independent restaurants. So there is always the case for this industry or that industry to get some money. But look what happened with the farmers. Yeah, we got to bail out the farmer. Farmer Joe down the road needs your support. So let's get this bill passed. They passed the bill. All the money goes to the big agribusinesses. It's a joke. It's a fraud. It is taking money from the middle class and supporting the wealthy. The big businesses, the corporations, the revolving door. But the average person can't see it because they got two rocks inside their head sloshing around. Maybe I went too far with that one. The U.S. posted its largest monthly trade deficit since 2006 in August as imports of consumer goods recovered to levels of earlier this year. You can see the chart in the bottom left corner, how we are looking at the U.S. monthly trade deficit picking up to $67 billion. It is rising considerably at this time. Imports of consumer goods and food rose in August and are the only broad categories of foreign trade that have surpassed year-ago levels. That likely reflects the roughly $1 trillion of fiscal support that the federal government has pumped into U.S. households through enhanced unemployment insurance, stimulus checks, and tax cuts. We'll see what happens, of course, in the coming months. This is not looking good at this time in the short term. I will keep track of it and let you know what's going on. Pretty compelling. UK stocks at valuations not seen since 2008. UK stocks are really cheap and are pretty compelling buy right now, but Brexit is complicating the investment landscape in Britain. They always tell you, no matter how high stocks are, no matter how silly a company might seem at that given moment, buy, buy, buy. You've got to know on your own. You can't take a look at these investment analysts and believe what they have to say. I see so many people that go in, whether it's on Reddit or whether it's on some video, and they see what that person is buying. They look at their past performance and they simply copy what they do. I get it. I know it's a lot of work to do it on your own, but it is such a risk to take the advice of anybody. It doesn't matter how high level these people are. I've seen the comments before. If it's good enough for Warren Buffett, it's good enough for me. You don't know what he's doing. You have no idea what's happening behind the scenes. You can't simply buy what somebody else does. They're never going to give you the full story. And I'll tell you right now, they're not going to tell you before they sell. Always have an exit plan ready. IMF warns of a long ascent to pre-crisis levels, but will soon upgrade its GDP forecast. That's right, it's excellent. They're going to upgrade it because they love each and every one of you. What do they want? They want more stimulus. They want it coming from the central banks. They want it coming from the governments. They want to increase the level of debt, and they want to be able to loan to every single country. They do this in order to have control over them. Supranational entities always want more and more control. This has been seen all over the world, in fact, historically, going back decades and decades. That's all for this video. If you found it informative, hit that thumbs up button. When you do, you are supporting me. I want to thank you for that. If you want to learn how to sell stuff online, talking about e-commerce, you can do so for free. I have an e-course available to every one of my subscribers. It's at theamazongps.com. If you want to know the financial system inside and out, but you want the easy explanation, save you the time. These two books will do that for you. Check them out at the link in the description. If you want the audiobook instead, themoneygps.com. Hold on, don't go anywhere. Have you seen this video? No? Well, you gotta watch it. Click it, I'll see you there.